Kate Hardcastle is a consumer expert from Insight with Passion. Good morning, Kate.
Good morning.
So what are the things which really make us cross about a bad online experience?
Well, we've flocked to online because we see it as an efficient provider of the goods and services we need. So anything that gets in the way of it being efficient becomes extremely frustrating. And something we hear about from consumers all the time is there is a technical glitch sometimes between the retail operating system online and people's warehouses, which means that they get told stock's in place, and actually when they come to buy it or they are awaiting it, they get an email saying, sorry, it's not actually in stock. Extremely frustrating for customers. But what's interesting, as you mentioned, is some of the smaller brands who've made their websites not only accessible but personable are really topping the charts on this. And I think it starts with a simple philosophy. If people actually build the technology around what people want rather than just what's available to them, they'll find that they create a website that their customers really enjoy.
And is that why the bigger retailers are struggling? Because they're kind of translating what they have in store into an online shop window, and it's a bit like moving a great big juggernaut around.
That's right. There's lots of operational issues happening behind the closed doors of retailers as they try and convert to a new way of retailing. If you add into that, some of these websites have been going a long time and they're a bit ready to topple over, so they keep bolting bits on to try and make it work better, and that often doesn't happen. And also that the consumers are using it much more. There's much more traffic, much more interest and engagement. But unfortunately, Danny, some people just see this as a catalogue that's online. That's not the way to view this. This is about building a platform to really create relationships for the future. And goodness knows, in this climate, we're going to need that.
So how much damage does it do a business like Homebase Sports Direct to have an online presence which isn't fit for purpose?
Significant. It's just bad customer service. And that doesn't matter, really, whether it's somebody at a till point who can't help you or being a bit surly, or a website that just frustrates you and doesn't provide you with what you want. Time's precious. Consumers are really savvy in terms of finding alternatives. And unfortunately, when customers do find something elsewhere, they take much more work, much more money to try and drive them back. So you really need to make sure that these are internet websites that are operating at the highest possible standard. And if not, that they're personable enough to explain that perhaps you're improving things. That's a crazy thing that we don't do in business. We don't tell people that we're trying to make things improve or easy to use and sort of bear with us on the journey or give them some thanks for sticking with you.
Thank you very much indeed, Kate Hardcastle from Insight with Passion. It is incredibly frustrating if you are trying to use online and it's all about speed.